जय जय राधा गब कुंड बिहारी जय राधा माधव कुंड बिहारी यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन जमुना तीर बन छी जमुना तीर बन छी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन बल्लव गिरीवर धारी गोपी जन बल्लव गिरीवर धारी यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीर बन छी यमुना तीर बन छी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी जय अमृता परमहंस परिव्राजराचार्यक्तिसिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी भगवान की जय अनंत कोटि वैष्णव की जय रामाचार्य श्री हरिदास ठाकुर की जय प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवाचार्य गौर भक्तमंद जय श्री राधा कृष्ण गो गोपनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरिवर्धन की जय वृंदावन धाम की जय नवदीप धाम की जय गंगा माई की जय जमुना माई की जय गुरु द्वारका धाम की जय स्वामी तो भक्तविंद की जय ऑल ग्लोरी टू जय श्री ऑल ग्लोरी टू जय श्री थैंक यू वेरी मच
टुडे वी हैव श्रील प्रभुपाद स्पेशल लेक्चर ऑन द ओकेशन ऑफ रथ यात्रा
वंदेहं
Padakamalam recorded
on 1971
in London. Sri Guran Vaishnava Bhansa Venung means flute. So, Kannantyam is playing on flute. So this Krishna's flute is not our imagination, it is in the Vedic literature. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, he likes to play on flute. Just like here in this material world also, there are many boys who like to play on flute. Where from this flute playing idea came? That answer is given in the Vedanta Sutra. Janma dasyajataha. All ideas, everything is coming from him, from Krishna. Unless there is in Krishna, there cannot be anything in this material world. Janma dasya. Just like Janma, here somebody is birthed from father or mother. So the symptoms of the father and mother, the facial expression, even a spot in the face, everything becomes manifest. And the child. So you can study what is God by studying yourself. That is Mayavad philosophy. They take it in a different way than I am God. Reflection. God, it is a God reflection. No, we are reflection. God is not our reflection. We are God's reflection. So, if we actually meditate upon our own constitution, then why we should conclude that God is impersonal? I am person, I am individual. I have got my individual opinion. I do not agree with others. Why? Because I am individual. You do not agree with me. I do not agree with you. Why? Because we are all individuals. Why God should be not an individual? He is also individual. That is the statement in the Vedas. Nitya nityanam chetanas chetananam. Ego bahunam vidadhati kaman. Nitta, nitta means eternal. As we are eternal, all. We change our body, we don't die. As we are changing daily, every moment, changing body. So, the final change means accept another body. This is also accepting another body, but imperceptible. The change is so quick, just like in the cinema pool, if there are so many pictures changing, but it is changing so quickly that we are seeing one picture, movie. So that is our ignorance. But actually, there are thousands of pictures changing in a moment, and you see that one picture is moving. Why do not study in this way? Similarly, every second our body is changing. Just like spoon. One after another. But I am the spirit soul is there. It's like the cinema spool is changing, but the seer is there. That is one, although the pictures are changing. Similarly, we are nitya. Nitya means eternal. And we are nitya, then why God should be dead? They say God is dead. And what is foolishness? You are part and parcel of God. You are living. You are existing. And why the original soul should be dead? So these are our foolishness. Meditation means to think over all this subject matter very intelligently, not like a rascal. That if I am person, why God should be imperson? If I am eternal, why God should be dead? This is meditation. To study diligently. If I have got an instinct to love others, so why God should not, God will not have this instinct to love others? If I have got attraction for the opposite sex, why God should not have? Why he should not be attracted by Radharani? Very simple truth. And why Radharani should not be attracted by Krishna? But the difference is, here everything is false. False means the attraction is not a real attraction. But there the attraction is real. Here I am attracted with a boy, with a girl. After 6 months, finished. Because there are so many defects. Therefore, the attraction does not exist. It is all defective. This body is false. False in the sense that it is an imitation. Just like you see one idol in the dress shop, very nice girl standing, but it is a false. Similarly, this body, made of material elements, is not our real body, false. Similarly, the girl's body is false, therefore because false, the so-called love and attraction is also false. Therefore, our so-called love breaks. There is no love here, it cannot be. There cannot be any love. This is that tendency is there. But due to this material contamination, here lust is going on in the name of love. Actually, it is lust. So, we should discriminate between lust and love. Love cannot be accepted unless it is reposed in Krishna. That is love. All other everything, that is lust. It appears to be similar. But love and lust, there is so much difference of value, just like gold and iron. Gold and iron. Real love is gold. How you can evaluate gold and iron on the same level? It is not possible. So, we have to learn real love. But that is how to love Krishna. Our whole process is training people how to love Krishna. Just like this temple for Krishna, we are all engaged in Krishna's service. nice throne, Krishna nicely dressed. But the atheist will say, these people are foolish. They have taken a brass idol and they are engaged. That is false. Actually, we are engaged in Krishna's service. We are dressing Krishna directly. We are offering flower Krishna. Krishna has kindly accepted the Archamurti incarnation to be handled by me. Otherwise, just like Arjuna saw the Virat Murti, the universal form of Krishna, he was trembled, he was afraid. He requested Krishna, please become again, just like my friend. This is very fair. So Krishna, because he is all-powerful, Brahma, Parabrahma. Parabrahma means the bigger than the biggest and the smaller than the smallest. Anuraniyang mahato mahiyang. Anu means particle. We have got idea, atom. Krishna can enter into the atom also. Annantarastam, paramanu chayantarastam. Paramanu means atom. Krishna can become so big that many universes can be put into his mouth. Just like Yashodama, mother Yashoda, he wanted to check whether you have eaten dirt. Show me your face, mouth. As soon as Krishna opened mouth, all the universes are in. And so, Yashodama, out of affection, she thought, this is something positive. I like clothes. That's all. That is God. Mother, you want to see whether there is some dirt within my mouth. You see, the whole universal darts are within me. They are called Mahato Mahiya. Within that mouth, he exhibited all the universes. How it is possible? Yes, it is possible. Just like in the globe, we see the whole world. Here is America, here is Asia, here is this, here is this. That is possible. It is a process only. To understand the process. Similarly, to understand God, it requires a process. You have to know the process, the secret process. There is bhakti. Bhaktyamamavijanati. Krishna says, only through devotional service you can understand Krishna. Otherwise, to understand God, Krishna is not very difficult. It is very easy. He becomes revealed to the devotees, but there is no difficulty. Simply, we have to become sincere devotee. Our service must be very sincere and authentic under the direction of authority. Then you will understand God. There is no difficulty. Tishamaham anukampartham. In the Bhagavad Gita, it is said, Tisham eva anukampartham. Tisham. Tisham means not ordinary person. Those who are devotees, sincere devotees. To show them special favor. God is kind to everyone, but is specially kind to his devotee. That is his special. He is kind to everyone. Otherwise, how everyone is eating? Nobody is starving. Eko bahunam vidadati kaman. Eko, that one eternal being. He is supplying everyone's necessity. And the plural number of eternals, they are dependent on this one. Eko bahunam vidadati. So we have to study Vedas through authoritative sources. We have to follow the rules and regulations. Then, in this life, we shall be able to understand what is God, what is Krishna. And as soon as you understand Krishna, you are liberated. Immediately. There is no doubt about it. Because without being liberated, nobody can understand Krishna. Nobody can understand Krishna. Tatu maang tatu tu gatva visadhita dhanantaram. The Bhagavad Gita is said that first of all you have to become liberated. Brahma Bhuta, that is called Brahma Bhuta. Identification with Brahma, that is liberation. Now you are identifying with this matter, material elements. Everyone is illusion. I am this body. Therefore, I am America. Therefore, I am India. Therefore, I am this. I am that. Everyone. This is called Jiva Bhuta. Ignorance. And as soon as one becomes Brahma Bhuta, he understands. Prasannatma, oh, I am neither American, nor this, nor that, I am eternal servant of Krishna. That is Brahma Bhuta. Simply to change the consciousness. At the present moment, our consciousness is material. I am identifying with matter. The same thing. Consciousness when changed, you identify with Krishna, Krishna's interest, then you are liberated. Thank you. Is that all right? Or if there is any question, you can make question. Yes. Yes. Yeah. Provided they take it seriously. Otherwise, if they keep their mentality differently, then according to my, one has to get a body. But just like so many boys, they come here in the beginning out of curiosity. But gradually, they get the chance of becoming devotee. Similarly, if they take the chance, then they will be liberated. They come out of curiosity, but if they take it seriously, then they will be liberated. Just like hospital is meant for curing disease. So once you take the treatment, if he simply goes and visits the hospital and thinks, now I am cured, how it can be? Hospital is suppose if I advertise that anyone who comes to this hospital, he will be cured of his disease. That's a fact. But if he thinks that I have come here, now I am going, then how will he be cured? To see Jagannath and the Rath Yatra, his way for liberation is open. But if he comes back again and entangles himself, then one goes to the doctor, he gives injection, the disease is cured. But again, he comes back and does the same thing so that he develops his disease again. So whose fault it is? This is called Hastisna. Hastisna, the elephant, takes part very nicely. And as soon as comes on the bank of the river or the lake, it takes dust and throws the body again. If we do that, then we shall remain always dirty. We go take bath, cleans, but don't take dirt again. That is not going. They become immediately mukta, liberated, but they come again, become entangled. If it is a fact, seeing Jagannath is mukta, that's how he becomes mukta. But if he again comes to Maya, then who can check him? Just like you are all on the path of liberation. But if you again come back to Maya, then where is your liberation? Why Jagannath in the Ratha here? If somebody comes here and sees his path for liberation is open, now he should protect himself. It's like disease, fever is subsided. Now one should be careful not to relapse the fever. That care is in my hand, everyone said. And if you become prone to be relaxed again, then again the same thing. Just like in Christian church, they confess. Of course, that is injection. That's all right. After confessing, the sins are excused. That's a fact. But if he comes back again, commits the sin, then what is the effect? But they are happy in that way, that after one week I shall go to the church and confess my sin, then everything will be neutralized. This is all right. Suppose on Sunday you become free from all contamination of your sinfulness. And Monday, you again do the same thing. So you become again contaminated. And you say on Tuesday, if you die, then you are dying with sins. Is it not? Then what is your condition? If the God or Christ excused you of your sinful life, that's all right. But when you come back, you don't commit again sin, then you are all right. But we have taken it as a business that we go to Sunday, neutralize all sins, and come back again and do the same thing. So, from logical point of view, suppose you do the same sinful activities, and if you die immediately, then you die with sinful activities, go to hell. What benefit you derive by confessing in the church? This business is going on. Now I have seen Jagannath. My liberation is guaranteed. Now I can do anything. This mentality will not give you liberation. You have seen Jagannath, your sinful activities are now neutralized, but don't commit again. Now make progress. Then your liberation is guaranteed. Is it clear? Namnath Vala just Sahi Papa Buddhi in every initiation he teaches. Chanting Hare Krishna mantra, once chanting Hare Krishna is sufficient to make us pure from all sinful activities, reactions. But if we commit sin again, in the hope that because I am chanting, this will be neutralized. That is the greatest sin. So, one side you should chant always Hare Krishna mantra so that you may not fall down. Another side you should be careful. No illicit sex life, no intoxication, no meat eating. In this way, if you carefully make progress, then your liberation is guaranteed. Just like doctor, if you go to a doctor for treatment of a disease, he gives you medicine. At the same time, he prohibits you, don't do this. So you take medicine and don't do this, follow the instruction, you are cured. But if you don't follow the don't do this and don't take the medicine regularly, then how you can expect cure? It may be, but it will take long time. But if you want quick, take it seriously. Just like Dhruvamana. In 6 months, he saw God. In 6 months. That's possible. He followed. Stop, I said. If you don't follow the regulatory principles and instruction, then our liberation will be delayed. Otherwise, it's guaranteed.
How do you develop the seriousness to find that you're always frivolous?
Seriousness? If you become serious, then you develop seriousness. If you are fickle, then how you can develop seriousness? Therefore, the injunction is jasya prasadat bhagavat prasad. We should be very serious to abide by the orders of the spiritual master. Then you are serious. If you think the spiritual master is a man like me, wisely following his instructions so strictly, then you are not serious. Then what is the use of your being initiated? This is seriousness. And we are singing daily, Jasya Prasada Bhagavat Prasad. What is the meaning of this? So if you don't follow the spiritual master, then how you can get his mercy? Mercy is always there. But if you don't take it, then spiritual master or his father will do. You have to take it. That is serious. Therefore, Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur said, that the order of my spiritual master is my life. I do not know whether I get liberation or not. That is not my business. My business is to carry out the order of my spiritual master. Vishwanatha Chakravarti says, if one is serious on this point, then he is. First of all, we have to approach a spiritual master who is actually a spiritual master. And then if we carry the orders of spiritual master, then everything is there. The same example, first of all, you find out a right physician and you put yourself under his treatment, follow his instruction, and the disease is cured. But if you go to a false physician, or if you are false, then the result will not take place. So, Dharati will be performed now.
Not 45 minutes.
I can go.
Yes.
Hare Krishna.